Why?
Well, something doesn't seem right here. I mean, it's we're making my grandmother's chicken soup that I grew up with my own little twist and turn. But I can't get started unless I get the feel, because cooking is about feeling it, about being a part of it, being in the moment. And for me to bring my grandmother's spirit into the kitchen with me, there's always Sinatra playing. And as you can see, my grandmother is all over my kitchen.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars.
All right.
Let me see what spring is.
Okay, let's get back to cooking. Anyway, we're going to get started with my grandmother's recipe. And I made some changes along the ways. I came from an Italian-Sicilian family. I grew up in New York. I just happened to live on the other side of the river. Now I'm in New Jersey. And you know what? Food was everything. Food, it was about family and food. That's what it was all about. Families would get together on Sundays. I mean, listen, every Sunday, like communion, we were eating meatballs, like a communion wafer every Sunday. But when we weren't eating pasta on Sunday, my grandmother would make some dishes, and this is one of them. And this is one of my favorite comfort food dishes that my grandmother made. So let me get started really quick. And by the way, back in the day, the women wore, house dresses. And you know what? Now that we're in the 21st century, this is what I call modern day woman house dress, okay? So maybe you were expecting, I still have the wooden spoon, but maybe you were expecting, you know, the heavy set Italian lady sitting in front of the stove stirring the pot. Not anymore. No way. This is how it goes, okay? Modern day woman, working, career, kids, the whole nine yards. This is how it's done. But I still have that wooden spoon because I never forget where I came from. Didn't come from silver. I came from wood. All right, so let's get started. I'm taking these chicken breasts. I always use chicken breasts. Keep the skin on. It keeps the flavor in it. Now, these are some pretty big breasts. Not these. These. And I'm jealous because these are really nice size breasts, don't you think? Anyway, these are the breasts that are going to go in the pot. This is my soup pot. I use this all the time. So you got to start with a nice size soup pot like this. I am going to take the chicken, put it in the pot. Now, everything you see, you just put it in like this. Don't be afraid. It's chicken. Everything goes in there. And by the way, don't forget, wash your chicken before you clean it up. Scrub it up a little bit. No soap, just water. Before you put it in the pot. Okay, so now what I have, everything you see here is going in that pot. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some of these carrots up. Looks like, you know, sad Bugs Bunny, but left his carrots here. So anyway, I remember I used to live upstairs from my grandmother's apartment, from my grandmother's. We had I swear to God, I think everybody in New York had two kitchens. Or if you came from an Italian family, there were two kitchens in every house. So she lived downstairs from us. My bedroom was right upstairs from her kitchen. So every morning I would smell coffee and garlic. Every single morning, because no matter what, my grandmother was cooking something with garlic, and it always started in the morning. So it was one of those memories that I could still smell it. I play it. I keep her memory alive by keeping these recipes going, changing them up a bit, and keeping those traditions. I myself have a son. My son's name is Dominic. You know, I made him make sure that he followed form with me. Where he was going to, you know, I wanted to bring those traditions, the old traditions that I grew up with, and make sure that he was able to, you know, learn some of the things that we did when I was a kid, some of the things that I've done to turn these recipes into, you know, our own and update them a little bit. So anyway, we're chopping up the celery, as you can see. And this is most of the work that you're gonna be doing with this old dish. It's so simple, but I've got some secret stuff going on. Some secret ingredients. So we're going to chop all this up. But you know what? I really, growing up Italian, everything happened in the kitchen. All of our conversations, our arguments, our fights, our love, our fun, our poker games. I mean, everything, you name it, happened in the kitchen. And I miss those days. And you know what I think? I think because a lot of us women and a lot of couples, both couples are working. Back in the day, it was always the woman that was home. I mean, I come from the corporate world. I work, you know, 30 years in corporate America. I own my own business. I raised a son. I mean, it's not like it used to be. And so, you know, sometimes you fall away from those Sunday dinners where everybody is, you know, getting together at the dinner table. And that's one of the traditions that I won't give up. I might not be able to be home to cook dinner for everybody, but come Sunday, everybody better sit their ass down and we're going to have a nice meal, because that's what we're going to do. I don't care what anybody's doing. I don't care who's fighting with who, who's not talking to what. Doesn't matter. Okay, so chop this all up, throw this into the pot with the chicken. So you got your carrots. You want to see this, Jack? You want to take a closer look? We're going to put this all in the pot. All right. There we go. Got it all in the pot. Now, I'm going to put the onion in here. I'm going to put some bay leaf in here. I put 3 because I overindulge with everything. I don't measure anything because it's just, I just wasn't taught that way. We're going to put some chicken broth in. I've got a, how many cups do I have? I have 4.5 cups. So here's the chicken broth. So just empty that in there. Okay. Have another 2 cups in here, actually. So just fill it up. So it's almost covering the chicken. Okay. Can you see that? Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little water in. I'm going to add some water. Just till it covers it up. There we go. Didn't have one of these when I was growing up. So much easier. I'm going to throw a little bit of salt. And some pepper. We're going to put this on a boil. And I'm going to throw a little cayenne pepper because I like things spicy and a little hot. Chicken soup is normally, you know, people think of chicken soup when they're sick and when they're cold. And yes, my son Dominic calls me and says, Ma, can you make me some chicken soup because I don't feel well. But this is such a good comfort food for all of the time. I mean, you don't have to be sick. It's just a feel-good food. It's good for the soul. And I love and enjoy this dish so much because it brings me back so many memories with my grandmother. And as you can see, she's always with me. She's always next to me in the kitchen. So I'm going to put a little bit of cayenne pepper to give it a little bit of spice. Now, I'm going to cover the pot. And we're going to let this cook. And we're going to let this cook for about 45 minutes to an hour. In the meantime, we got 2 other things that we need to do. Now, to prioritize this, there are 2 things that we need to do. There's a secret ingredient, though, that I'm not telling you that's in there, but you didn't see me put it in because I'm not going to show you. I'll have to show you later. So the other thing that you need to do in the meantime, while the soup is cooking, there's another Sunday tradition. Or not Sunday tradition, but a family tradition. Well, what do we do? You can't cook Italian without wine. So it's not going in the soup. It's going in my glass. So let's enjoy. This is another thing I enjoy doing, was having wine with my grandmother. It was always a great red wine or Chianti. And we would sit and we would just talk about food and friends and loves and past loves and just crazy family things. And I mean, like, look, when I tell you my grandmother's with me all the time, she is with me all the time. I mean, this is where my favorite and best memories growing up was all about being in the kitchen, about food and family. So cheers, Grandma. This one's for you. I'm making you chicken soup. You might not be a little too happy with a couple of things that I'm going to change up, but I think you're going to like it. Chin chin. So while the pot of soup is cooking, and it's gonna take 45 minutes on a nice good boil, I'm gonna put some orzo. So my grandmother used to make her chicken soup and put a little bit of orzo pasta. Little ditalini, orzo, I always chose orzo. So there's always a little bit, some people put rice, sometimes she made rice, but I always liked orzo. She put it in there one time and I never stopped. Now, true story, funny, true story. Growing up, making chicken soup, I never wanted the chicken in my chicken soup. Yes, yes, that's what I just said. I did not put chicken in my chicken soup. So my grandmother, because I was the princess, would make sure that when she made the chicken soup and all the base that I just made, that once everything was done, she would strain my chicken soup. So I would just have the broth and then scoop out the carrots because I don't like the celery. I'm a little picky about my stuff. But anyway, I'm gonna make the orzo pasta with chicken broth. So I put four cups of chicken broth in here. And when this starts to boil, we're gonna add the orzo pasta in here. And at the end, I'm going to dish this out on the bottom, ladle it with the soup, and I've got some extra surprises to go on top. So stay tuned, and we're just gonna have to sip on our red wine while we wait for the pot to finish. How much wine do you think we can drink before the chicken soup is finished? It's anyone's guess. Cheers.